this flare, the oxygen will ignite.
Highly flammable area. I think we gotta get the hell out of Dodge. Okay, I thought I had to do that. Wow.
Extreme external temperatures detected.
No kidding.
Slug suit has regulated body temperature to benchmark level.
Level.
The fire systems just went haywire over here, John.
Oh, another obnoxious one. I mean,
I cleared the vines.
Not obnoxious.
With a flamethrower.
Obvious.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Fire in Oxygen Gardens 1, 3, 5, 6, 9. Fire in Oxygen Gardens 2, 7, 8.
What, no flame retardant? Oh god.
Fire suppression system activated.
Compromised.
Warning. Fire suppression system compromised. Warning.
Shit! Oxygen production has been compromised. Are the bios still intact?
Oh.
Oh god, please don't say burn them out.
I burnt them out.
Just the one on this level.
Nah.
Cause a chain reaction, John. They're all going up. We have a time limit now. Hours at most.
Get my daughter right now.
Okay. Fire climbs the wall. In a small fraction of time it must have taken the vines to mount it. Sharp tongues of orange and yellow dart out of the burning laboratory, consuming the organic matter hungrily, but leaving no mark on the curved composite walls. The smell of compost fills the hot air. The vegetation is being reduced to noxious mulch by the creeping flames. Years of work destroyed in flames. Many of the thick roots still smolder. Occasionally, one emits a high-pitched squeal as steaming moisture escapes the root flesh. So I guess we can go in there now. Alright. That was exciting. Oh, now we're clear of the vines so we can continue downward.
You little shit! What have you done?
Why burn stuff?
Listen to me.
Correct.
I'm gonna make sure you burn for what you and your friends have done to me. To my home!
Please, I have nothing to do with this.
You won't get much further.
Uh-oh. Does he control the elevator?
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Where is she, Taylor? Where is Rebecca?
She's in the containment area at the other end of Seed.
So, are we in Seed now? At least it's not a planet-side elevator filled with advertising screens. Power pad. The high-voltage wireless power pad provides a portable energy source for engineers and mechanics. Oh. Energy source, okay. toolbox. Okay, something's wrong with that. The floodlight illuminates the work area efficiently, giving off much needed heat. Is this cold down here?
Looks like this place is being expanded.
Seed was always expanding.
What I got?
That place scares me.
Ah.
Sorry.
Hope I didn't miss that. Like, put my mouse too far off the screen again. Try again. I still got this extra queen's milk. High temperature slug gun. Oh, cool. I've got my mala. My malin killer right here. So don't need that now. This area seems to have been undergoing a renovation. We can go that way. Construction plastic. Most of this room has been covered in heavy-duty plastic sheeting. As with many of the surfaces, this elevator shaft has been wrapped in a protective covering. Contamination is a concern here. A large metal scaffold spans the room's width. What are these things? Closed power cell housing? This lithium ion fuel cell provides high density energy storage and remote wireless charging. Hanging wires. Dangling wires resemble nooses. Okay. We have death on our minds here. Anything else?
These don't go well together.
What needs power? Does this need power? This gun? Do we need to charge it?
It doesn't work like that.
I'm sorry, guy.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
Still got an empty pistol. Did I put it? No, I thought I put it there.
Probably not a good idea.
Alright. I keep running across this thing. What was that? Oh, this is a... What was that? When I ran across... I don't know. Hello. Oh. I'm not actually looking at anything on this, aren't I? Alright.
That's just crazy. Although... No. Crazy. Maybe. No.
Doubt it. Do we want any of these wires?
I don't think this will fit.
Well, we can go this way then.
Warning. Halothane hepatotoxicity is at an elevated level.
Oh. Yeah, that's death. I'm like, ah, robot.
Shit. Where is Rebecca?
She's in the containment area at the other end of the sea.
Thanks.
sorry.
Okay, so maybe I'll shoot the robot with the slug gun before it turns around and kills me? Either that or we're taking cover. Either one.
Warning. Halothane hepatotoxicity is at an elevated level.
Figured I'd shoot it, and so I walk slowly over to it.
Shit. Where is Rebecca?
I love that music. Are we gonna do that every time? Okay, I'm gonna take cover.
Warning. Halothane hepatotoxicity is at an elevated level.
Birthing laboratory. Sink. Does this thing come all the way over? It stops there. Okay, good. This stainless steel sink stands out after the successive levels of hell you've traversed. It's equipped with a variety of cleaning agents that are presumably safe for skin. Nothing of any use can be gained from the empty crates that litter this area. Mutagen Laboratory. The sheeted canopy leads to a facility named the Mutagen Laboratory. It goes that way. Birthing Laboratory. One of Kane Corporation's best-kept secrets. Oh, guess we're about to find out. This is restricted. Restricted access. Authorized personnel only. Black Void. The shapeless maw of the unlit void. The void is seemingly endless. No beginning or end. How can you have such a huge void inside a ship? Airlock. The airtight steel frame forms a secure barrier to the adjacent room. Power pad. A technology that provides an energy boost for heavy-duty equipment. Biohazard. Sink. Not even a handprint marks the surface of this sparkling clean sink. It might be the type with a built-in cleaning drone. Oh, wait. It's gonna turn off by itself, then. No description for the robot. Platform. Elevator platform. This elevator was constructed to lower its passengers quickly into the thick darkness below. Sounds lovely. Can I even get through that? That's my question. A few storage crates sit like sentries outside the entrance to this restricted area. Alright, I guess we're done. I wanted to shoot the gun at it, but he just starts running over to it. Oh, as I saved, it stopped. I want to try again, though. Let's see if I can get rid of it. I'll wait till it's just starting to walk away. Or roll away, whatever. Yeah, no. It was worth a try. Oh, it's still going back here? Load my save. I don't want to hear those two lines every time. Gotta stop dying for a little bit. Alright, let's go into the birthing laboratory.
What? I can't even...
The heck? What?
What do you see?
What kind of a monster would do this?
Oh, they've taken the...
These poor women.
The fetus is out.
This is torture. This is...
Science.
Huh. Evil science. So that 17-year-old girl was lucky. She was not able to go through this torture and still died anyway, but... Pregnant woman. That's horrible. Seated in the chair is a woman in her mid-30s, head shaved, limbs atrophied, tumescent in pregnancy. She's connected to a machine that feeds and sedates her. She's still alive? I guess they're alive. They're breathing, yeah. She's trying to communicate, but her words are little more than slurred vowels. Her throat is dry, and she is clearly extremely weak. You remember seeing Renaissance-era sculptures of nuns in Holy Communion, their eyes rolled back, bodies contorted in ecstatic agony. There's a hint of that expression across this unconscious woman's face. So yeah, they're alive. A fine mist sprays down, anointing the bodies of the women below. It's anesthetic. This is for high-density energy storage and remote wireless charging. They've got all these charging cells in every area. Now we got these. Hybrid fetus? The horror of this enlarged fetus sac is matched only by the horror within its fleshy walls. The awful engorged placenta hangs like a ripened fruit. Each one has its own description. The fluid sac rocks gently to and fro, containing neither a human nor animal, but a medical marvel nonetheless. Who cares if it's a friggin' medical marvel? The pulsing sacs bleed their nutrient mixtures onto the floor, where the liquid congeals in clustered cysts. The sac of organic matter sways peacefully in its slumber, punctuated by a pulsating movement from within. There's a calmness about the suspended womb, but the pungent smell of amniotic fluid makes prolonged observation unbearable. An organic pulsing fluid sac holds the fetus, an external placenta. There is something noticeably peculiar about this artificial placenta. On closer inspection, there are tiny ragged apertures across the surface, almost as if it's been eaten at from within. Oh, so this thing's feeding on it already. Nutrient tubes. Tubes convey the nutrient mixture from the machines connected to the women over to the brood against the wall. Oh, jeez. Chemicals of an unknown origin are contained within the nutrient growth. Portable gurney. A wheeled stretcher to transport the sick and injured easily, but to where? Disconnecting these poor women from the machines and wheeling them away on this gurney would be an easy choice if it weren't for the fact that such an act would surely kill them. We're gonna put them out of their misery as well? Was this? Nutrient tubes? Yeah, I saw that. Bloated fetus. The thing inside the incubator is anathema to nature. The poor creature should not exist, and what life it shows is reluctant and painful. A division of Kane Corporation. What's a division of Kane Corporation? This whole place? Machinery. Although it is only a wall of gauges, they cluster and protrude like the offspring birthed on a Suriname toad's back. Complex wires and cables hang from power units in the ceiling. Even dormant, they thrum with power. Well, what am I going to do with all this? Fluid drainage. A strange black goop when the birthing table drains away into the floor. The smell of almonds wafts from the viscous steam of fluid. Almonds? Oh, I'm like, who the hell is that? That was me. This one's not locked. Or just for display. Do I, like, charge my gun with this or something? I had trouble picking that up.
These don't go well together.
Alright, I don't know what we charge with that. Oh, computer terminal. This terminal appears to be unlocked and ready for use. Didn't see that.
They don't look human.
Hybrids?
I can't tell.
Yeah, hybrid. Confirmed. How lovely.
Must have families and lives.
What do we take?
Can't do anything for them now. Soon this ship will run out of oxygen. They won't be in pain for much longer.
A second in this place is more torture than anyone should bear.
I agree. So is Malin behind this too? A bandage. We got a bandage.
Hello. I'm here to help. I'm gonna help you. Just close your eyes.
Am I gonna kill her? Oh god.
Don't worry. I'm here. I'm gonna help you. Soon you'll be out of here. This is just a bad dream.
So horrible.
Just breathe in and out. Soon you'll wake up from this.
A portable defibrillator. Oh, there's a couple things over there that I missed. Doesn't care about going to that, huh? Defibrillators used in the case of birth complications. Am I gonna kill them with the defibrillator? Like stop their heart instead of start it?
A defibrillator. And it looks like it's fully charged.
Oh, we can charge it with this. Well, it's already fully charged, but... Okay, I am full of stuff now. Portable defibrillator. What happens if I try to use it on this?
I don't know what I was thinking there. No, that won't work. I think that'll just break it. I don't think this will fit. I think that'll just break it. I don't know what I was thinking there.
I don't know either. Okay, here's a terminal. Birthing Laboratory, Project Seed, revised. Version 6. Observation Report 0001 by Dr. C. Williams. Her vital signs are steady. Certain hormonal levels are extremely high, but I'm countering this with a judicious administration of depressants in each case. Survival chances, very high. She is young, healthy, and there are no signs of any infections or complications capable of disrupting the birth. Recommendations, keep under observation. Prepare for phase one treatment. So these people that volunteer for this whatever they've been told that this is, they just disappear. No one wonders where they've gone. I'm sure they do, but observation report 0002. There's a Dictum doctor, Dr. C. Backman. The subject, despite her promising early progress, appears to be failing. Supposition is that she cannot withstand the foreign genetic structure that is being fused into her body. Oh geez, I wonder why. Typical signs of rejection are being displayed. Recommendations. Observe for an additional 24 hours. If there are any signs of improvement, then termination... Oh, if there are no signs of improvement, sorry, then termination and disposal of the patient is recommended. Observation report 03. The subject is progressing well, as well as being aesthetically attractive. Like that matters. She has all the other genetic traits required. Initial concerns about her suitability, voiced by Dr. Mallon, chiefly due to the number of her sexual partners, have been proven unfounded. Oh God. She'll be a perfect carrier. The hybrid DNA is fusing to my satisfaction. Apart from a small amount of pain, her body appears to be coping with the adjustments. I have prescribed her a steady dose of anesthetic to keep her subdued and comfortable. Subdued. So be puts people like fully aware of what's going on. Hybrid subject number 302. Oh, these are observation reports, and this is hybrid subject number 302 by Dr. G. Mallon, the man himself. Since delivery, hybrid subject 302 has been kept inside an incubator. Due to its respiratory distress, assisted breathing is required. Cardiac arrest has occurred, and the use of automated external defibrillators has been required to revive the child. I deduce that the conditions and sickliness are due to the late molecular bonding between hybrid and host DNA in the mother. A weak nervous system is also highly likely in this case, but the subject's regenerative abilities can be stimulated with steroids. Conclusion. The child is weak, but will survive. The mother is suitable for continued breeding. Oh my God. You monster! I'll kill you all! We're gonna defib these people? Do we defib these too?
I don't think that'll work.
Is it what we're supposed to do? Kill them?
No, that won't work.
Defib this?
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
So I wonder what we're going to use the defibrillator for.
This isn't going to work.
Uh-huh.
I think that would break.
Oh.
No, that's ridiculous.
I tried on all of them.
I think that would break.
Not sure which one of these two I did, so...
I think that would break.
Okay, we're not gonna be doing anything with them just yet, then. What if I put a bandage over the fluid drainage?
I don't think that'll work.
Not sure why I felt like doing that. Oh, portal windows, a room with a view. A view to a kill. It was worse than death. I'm gonna wait till it goes. What if I place a defibrillator on its path? That wouldn't do anything, right? We need to activate it. All I can say is that we go to the Mutagen laboratory next. Oh my God, what?